Grammy winner Kirk Whalum is known all over the world, but he always comes back home to Memphis, Tennessee.
And thank God he does. Mm-hmm. And beginning this weekend, he's giving a special gift to his hometown. Kafe Kirk debuts Sunday at the Halloran Center downtown. How are you?
That's right, Kafe Kirk. And
that's
it's
so awesome.
Designed for you guys.
Designed
it's
for
so
us?
Perfect.
Absolutely.
Can you take us on a tour, Kirk, if
yes,
you would?
Yes, it's the series. It's going to be first Sundays at the Halloran for now, every other month.
Yeah.
But Kafe Kirk is that space where people can come and enjoy some sort of elevated music that really it sort of lifts people up.
Grown folk music.
Grown folk music.
Relaxing Sundays.
We're gonna and invite special grown folk, like for instance, this first is gonna be Lindsay Webster, who is amazing, coming from New York.
Wow.
The second one in December is a lady called Sheila E. Yeah.
Oh,
Sheila E.
Yeah, yeah, I think we've heard of her.
Yes.
It's going to be pretty outstanding, but this one you don't want to miss, Lindsay Webster, this Sunday.
So how did you find her? How did you identify the artist you wanted to
invite? Well, that's the nice thing about doing these festivals all over the country. You bump into, and all over the world, really, you bump into these artists, you're like, oh my God, where have you been all my life? And Lindsay's like that. She's just the girl next door who just happens to sing.
So, Kirk, for me, or for a Memphis music lover or music lover, period, I want those behind-the-scenes stories.
Yes.
Will we get any of that flavor from some of your friends?
I'm glad you asked.
Yes.
We're going to do interviews with each and every one of our special guests, including Lindsay, and she'll talk a little bit about her path, and especially on this series, Kafe Kirk. The word Kirk means church, just in case you didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, so the idea is this is a space where you get to kind of be spiritual. You say, well, you know what? This is my path. And I'm not a this, or I'm not a Christian, I'm not a this, but I do feel like my music is spiritual.
Yeah.
And this is why. And so that I think it's important because, you know, you don't want to sort of put people in a box and say, either you're this or you're that.
Right.
But you do want to empower not just the special guests, but the audience to say, this is a spiritual.
So it's about
now,
community.
Kirk, you could do this any place around the world, but you are doing it here. Why here in Memphis?
I like being able to, you know, get on one of those bird scooters and go to work.
watch out for the fingers, because, you know, you could have an accident and then the world would have to wait for a little sax.
You know, Memphis is known for blues and R&B and all, and, you know, Beale Street. So we want to expand that. We want people to also know Memphis for jazz and this other all kinds of different music. I think that it's time for that.
So what are you going to do for us this morning?
So I'm going to do this season that we're in, I'm playing happy songs.
Okay, we need that.
Okay, I'm going to play a song called The Sunny Side of the Street.
Oh, praise Jesus.
We'll step out of the way, man.
Let me know if you find that sunny side. Here is where to go. Thank you.
Thank you.